Hey friends, welcome back. We're continuing on in the series of fall gourmand fragrances videos. I recently did a milky and creamy fragrances video. Here's the thumbnail. Please check that out after this video if you haven't done so already. And I'll also link below a series of videos that has all of the sort of edible gourmand types of notes in them. Coming up after this video, we're going to get into chocolate and coffee and caramel and fall spicy fragrances and beautiful femme fatale vanillas for the fall before we then venture, wow, it's going to come soon, into winter territory and those deeper, richer, more beast mode types of fragrances for that time of year. Today, we're going to focus on fragrances that have a strong nutty accord. By that, I mean almond, I mean pistachio, hazelnut, chestnut, maybe some others. I don't think I have a walnut fragrance, but there are walnut fragrances and others out there. I've picked 12 from my collection that I'd love to chat with you about. And I will put some others in the pinned comment below that didn't make it into this video for time's sake. We're going to go ahead and kick off with one that people have shunned. She's no longer the it girl of YouTube, but she's still an it girl in my heart. And she is rocking tough with me in my collection. That is Elie Saab, Girl of Now. I will say about this fragrance, some people find it to be a little bit overwhelming because it is so thickly sweet. And it isn't a sort of like cotton candy sweetness. It's a very thick, almost gourmandy type of sweet. The primary notes here are pistachio and almond combined together. Also a pear note, an orange blossom, and sweetness from tonka bean. I find this to just be simply divine when I wear it. As you can see, I've been making my way through this bottle. I've had this bottle since probably early on in my YouTube channel, somewhere in winter of 2021, and have been making my way through it. I enjoy spraying this all over. I love that it still has a perfumey touch while still having the gourmand aspect of the pistachio and the almond. I will say I get more of like the creamy almond, like almost in the marzipan type of direction than I do whatever pistachio might be in here. But this is just, I don't understand why people have decluttered this or gotten rid of it. I think it is still beautiful. I enjoy the bottles. Nice little hefty work of art here with the Art Deco touches on it. Check this out. This is really quite a lovely fragrance. And I like the flanker Girl of Now shine as well. Absolutely beautiful with a little bit of a pineapple note, but that's not what we're talking about in this video. Let's move on. Second on my list is one that I talked about in my August Fragrance Awards. I think I gave this best bottle. This is another one like Girl of Now that still retains this perfumey nature while featuring a prominent almond accord, Le Baiser de Dragon from Cartier. Love the bottle on this. And I mentioned in that video that I get something different from this fragrance each time, but the almondiness of this remains throughout. It's a perfumey almond, meaning it's almost like an interpretation of almond rather than just a pure nutty scent that it has. But I do like it nonetheless. I find this to be a very sensual fragrance. It's almost like a very intimate hug in a bottle, not enormously projecting, but definitely will get you noticed, has some presence and longevity to it, not deep into the evening time. When I say longevity, I feel like I need to take a second here. When I say longevity, noting that many of today's fragrances don't last very long, right? The way that beast mode fragrances of the 70s and 80s did. When I say a fragrance has longevity, I mean in the 6 hour range or beyond. Even 4 hours to me is acceptable. 6 hours and beyond is even a little bit better. I don't need, like I always say, fragrances to last me all the way through the midnight, you know, bewitching hour and all of that. I do usually spray my fragrances very early in the morning. And if they last me for the workday, like through dinner time, I'm super thrilled. Even if they last me through right about lunch or after, I'm happy with that too. So this one here, I would say, it takes me to like mid-afternoon into dinner time just fine. It obviously gets a little bit softer as some fragrances do, but it still maintains its presence. So accompanying the almond is a little bit of white florals, a tiny bit of woodiness. It has an amaretto accord that gives it like that almondy booziness also. So anyway, the fragrance is sensual, lovely, I think very feminine, womanly. I don't know, it's just like that really sort of put together type of feeling when you've got your favorite outfit on, everything's hugging you right, your hair's done right, your makeup's on point, and you want to put on just that elegant, finishing, feminine touch. By the way, I think this would smell great on gentlemen as well, but a nice perfumey, almondy, amaretto type of fragrance. Number three today is one that people either love or actually dislike, and I'll explain why I think people may dislike this. This is from Masque Milano, and this is Madeleine, and it's one that I tested before and wasn't sure that I really wanted. In fact, I think I might have said a pass, like it was a pass or no, and then you know how it goes. I saw it on sale on where? Joma Shop. I'm a Joma Shop partner. I have a link below if you'd like to shop for this or any of the other fragrances I'm talking about through there. So this was on sale, I want to say $70-ish, and I took the plunge, and I think I like it. I can't say that I love it at the moment, but I will say that it's a like. I can see why people don't like this. So first, let me tell you about it. Chestnut, a creamy chestnut. Maybe, like, depending on the weather, it comes off a little bit more milky than creamy, but it's a like a musky, vanillic chestnut fragrance. And chestnut has a very particular smell that's a little bit hard to describe. I will say that on the opening, it comes across almost like a burnt peanut butter type of smell that I think is off-putting. That literally lasts for about 5 to 10 seconds and then dissipates super quickly. And you're left with like a toasted chestnut. Chestnuts roasting by an open fire. Let me talk about this for a second because I recently had an experience that I think you'll find comical. I've always loved the smell of chestnuts, but it really wasn't until this past winter that I actually ate chestnuts. I've smelled them being roasted, and I know what they smell like, and I know what they smell like in fragrance. However, and I know what they smell like in candles also. This winter, we ended up picking up some chestnuts, and much to my shock and dismay, they were a little bit slimy. So I won't be eating chestnuts, but I do like the smell of them roasting. Of course, it reminds me of the holidays because of the song and all of that. So chestnut is almost like, imagine peanut butter on toast. That's kind of like what I get from a roasted chestnut smell. It's different than an almond or pistachio or macadamia kind of scent. Each nut has its own sort of nuance to it. So know that, okay? Think about peanut butter on a really toasted piece of bread. That is what chestnuts smell like to me. Let me know if you agree. Tell me in the comments what chestnut smells like to you. And again, that's if it's not accompanied by spices and all of the rest. Anyway, that smell plus some vanilla plus some musk is what I get from this fragrance. Love the bottle. I think the bottle is just precious with the woman with the glasses on it, the little motif or symbol or whatever that is graphic there on the front. And I like the tops. So my one and only Masque Milano bottle. I've tried several others and liked them, but I haven't taken the plunge to purchase any others. So let me know if you have recommendations from this line that I should definitely check out. I will say about this fragrance that it's more on the moderate side in terms of projection and longevity. So keep that in mind if that's the sort of thing that's important to you before purchasing. Let's keep going. Although the next one is marketed toward men, ladies, don't sleep on this fragrance. It is so good. This is Pegasus from Parfums de Marly. I love, love, love the sort of creamy, vanillic, almond nature of this fragrance. It also has a pretty noticeable dose of powderiness to it. I wouldn't call it a powdery fragrance, but it's definitely that powder's on the cast of players here, if you will. Oh, I just think this is divine. Underneath the fragrance is a lovely sandalwood and a little touch of an aromatic note or two in here that I think then make this, you know, suitable for the gentleman also. But it's such a gorgeous unisex, maybe slightly feminine for me, almond vanilla fragrance. This is really, really good. And again, watch for those sales, you all, on Joma Shop. This line shows up sometimes on sale. I will, when that happens again, post another video about recommendations, but this is one that I picked up in the recent brand-wide sale that Joma Shop had. It's like a flash sale for 48 hours. And I want to say that I got this under 200. It was like in the 150 to 200 range, somewhere in there, if I remember correctly, for the full 4-ounce bottle. Really, really good. So a fragrance I don't hear anybody talking about and absolutely needs to be in this category and, to my surprise, needs to be in a beast mode video somewhere, and I'll explain why. This is from Boucheron. I do like this line of fragrances. I think it's like the equivalent of like their private or privé or whatever line. They're special fragrances. I don't have them all. I think I only have two, but I've sampled others and they're all really quite nice. Anyway, no, I have three. I have this one, I have Ombre d'Alexandra, and I have Oud de Carthage. This is Feve Tonka de Canaima. Okay, so let me tell you the story. When I wore this for the first time, I swore that it didn't have a lot of projection and longevity. I thought it had faded on me, you know, a few hours after I had put it on. I sprayed quite a bit. And my friends, it was way deep into the day after my work day We were walking down the aisle at Lowe's. I was in front of my husband and he was a good 20 feet behind me. And he was like, your fragrance is so strong. And I was like, what? Because it was into the evening and I just knew that this had gone away. So some reviews on this talk about it not lasting long. I think we just get nose blind to it. But let me tell you about the fragrance. Definitely an almond, and it's not a sweet almond. It's more like a flatter, what I call like a flatter almond type of note. Vanilla, tonka beans, some sandalwood. It has a slight bit of an herbal note somewhere in the background that I can't quite sort through, but this is lovely on, and it gets deeper and sweeter and slightly like ambery on your skin as the day progresses if you are able to pick the note up. So according to my husband, this was just like super loud and strong. By the time I couldn't smell it anymore, I would say it was about lunchtime. Like I said, I'd gotten a little sweeter, more ambery, but apparently this was like the Energizer Bunny that kept going and going and going. So for those of you that like long-lasting beast mode scents at a decent bargain, I did get this one off of Joma's shop too. I've seen it occasionally, I think on FragranceNet, maybe even Fragrance by CA, don't recall, but definitely check out Joma's shop to see if they have this available. And I want to say I got it like right at the $100, either below or right above that range for this full 4 ounce beautiful bottle. So I have several from this line of fragrances from Trussardi called La Vie de Milano, and I think they are all fashioned over sights and sounds on a shopping lane, from a shopping lane rather, somewhere in Italy. I think some of you know, so please drop the details in the comments if you'd like. This one is called Aperitivo Milanese Porta Nuova. We're going to call it Aperitivo for short. And this fragrance, I wore it recently. Just delightful. You have to be a fan of powder for this fragrance. It definitely has a strong powdery facet to it and a lovely almond, like fresh out of the bag type of an almond. Oh, this is just so lovely. It's got a softness from vanilla and this touch of sophistication from the prettiest, coolest, most structured iris note. I always think of iris, like I associate iris with like sophistication and class and good manners. And I think this is just a really delightful, very polite almond powdery iris vanilla fragrance. I want to say that it's like light in texture. However, it definitely has some heft to it. I sprayed pretty heavily with this and it filled up a room and lasted quite a bit of time, I would say, again, in that moderate range from like 4 to 6 hours before it sort of settled down. So this is really beautiful. I have found this also, these on Joma's shop and sometimes on FragranceNet. So check around to see who is selling this line of fragrances or which, you know, discounter is selling these. Lovely. I think they retail for the upper hundreds, maybe even into the two range. I don't know. But I've gotten all of mine in the probably like $70 to $100 range. I think this one was $70-something on Joma's shop when I picked it up. Really quite nice. Very soft, but with presence, if that makes sense. Very ladylike, very classy, very sophisticated, a nice, well-mannered, powdery almond fragrance. This next fragrance is discontinued, but you can still find it on the gray market on discount sites, and it's absolutely worth hunting down. It is the glorious Armani Code Cashmere. I like this so much that I have a backup bottle. I don't have backup bottles of many fragrances because I just don't need them. And in fact, I've sold many of them off, but this one I did not sell off. I still have it. This is probably, for me, one of the most underrated sexy fragrances, like of all time. Has a beautiful, very creamy almond along with orange blossom and a jasmine sambac and a touch of like deep, almost leatheriness to it in the very far background. A slight bit of maybe not like the texture of powderiness, if you will, without smelling powdery, and wears beautifully on the skin. Worth checking out. The almond to me is very forward in the same way that it is in Girl of Now. Now that one is more heavy on the floral notes, I think, than maybe this one is here. The floral notes are an accompanying player for the almond, and it goes in a slightly different direction with that jasmine sambac. But I adore this enough to have a backup bottle of it, Armani Code Cashmere. Speaking of discontinued fragrances, and if you are a fan of Chestnut, I have trouble pronouncing this name. I'm going to attempt it, but it's on the screen, Tubereuses, Castane. So from the Maison Lancome line, I probably pronounce that different every time I attempt it. Discontinued, kind of one of those unicorns if you can hunt it down and like the idea of that chestnut. Remember that it's like a toasted type of scent, if you will, peanut butter on toast type of nutty accord with tuberose. And I feel like there's something heavier in here, heavy and oily, like almost like a a deep, thick vanilla in the background. Tonka bean, very sweet, floral, but heavy on that chestnut also. Has a lot of like chewiness and texture to it as a fragrance. Long-lasting, sort of cuddly, but one that I think is a little peculiar for folks. And so I would say sample it, but there's really no way to sample it unless you know someone who is decanting their particular bottle. It's one that you would have to take a chance on. And I do have to say the tuberose is prominent alongside that chestnut. And there's just this deep, sweet, almost vanillic nature to it that probably comes from tonka bean. But there's got to be some other notes that are in the vanilla direction that give this fragrance thickness and chewiness and base. Absolutely beautiful fragrance. In that same Maison Lancome line, and I don't really like to feature a lot of fragrances from the same house in one video, but it really deserves its own mention, and that is Jasmine's Marzipan. This had its moment on YouTube where it was all the rage back in probably 2019 into 2020, like that time frame. Somewhere in there, this blew up on YouTube. I didn't get a full bottle. I got this size, which has done me just fine. This fragrance lasts a long time, and it's a really nicely done, heavy on the jasmine fragrance. You do need to be a jasmine lover for this. And it has that marzipan, which is for me almost, it's almond paste is what marzipan is, like crushed almonds. So it has like a buttery, almost again, oily texture in the same way that the fragrance before does. Very thick fragrance on. And for people that are floral lovers and jasmine in particular, it has a little bit of a soapy texture to it that I think keeps this from being too serious of a fragrance. Although it has a lot of base and depth and roundness to it. I think this is one of those fragrances that can be polarizing. People either love it or despise it, particularly people that are not into jasmine. This is jasmine heavy, so you may not enjoy this. But for those of you that like jasmine and you like the idea of the paste, marzipan paste, that like buttery thickness of crushed almonds, take a look at, take a sniff, Jasmine's Marzipan. So another sort of hidden gem type of fragrance, I've seen it talked about here and there very infrequently. It's Kiss Me Intense from Nicolai. Oh, lovely little almond vanilla powdery number with, I think it's a touch of iris, maybe some heliotrope. This is so delightful. It has some other notes in there, maybe a little citrus and a little floral, but very, very far in the background. Mostly this is a vanilla and powdery and almond fragrance that is very much a cozy sweater weather fragrance. Beautiful for bedtime, beautiful for date night, beautiful for when you want to be intimate with just one other person, like in cuddle mode, and want that person to smell your scent without everyone else being able to sniff you. Definitely a close-up type of fragrance and just delightful. Not cloying at all, not overly sweet. Nice, mature fragrance without being heavy and overly dense. Really nice, light, powdery, vanillic almond fragrance. Up next is a fragrance that I personally could not wear. I tried to love this and it just wasn't for me, but I have to give the fragrance its flowers. It is beautiful in its own right, and a lot of people love this fragrance, and I can see why. So again, if you are a chestnut fan and you like a milky fragrance, check out This Is Her from Zadig and Voltaire. So this one is more like a fresh chestnut. It doesn't have quite the toasted smell that I've been referencing for chestnut throughout this video. And it's accompanied by this creaminess, maybe milky depending on some people. For me, sometimes when I wore it, it was milky, and sometimes it felt a little more dense and creamy. It's actually like a whipped cream type of note that's in the composition. And it definitely has for me a prominent sandalwood, a nice, soft, almost like a spicy sandalwood in the fragrance. There was something about this that just didn't sit right for me on my chemistry, but a lot of people really love it. And so I definitely wanted to give it a minute of shine here as a classic nutty fragrance that is also affordable. This one shows up on discount sites, usually somewhere in the $50 to $75 range. So check this out. Love the bottle on this. It's kind of a quirky bottle with one straight edge and one like a almost like a ripped edge or an iceberg edge or something like that. So it's a really artistic little piece. Neat fragrance, just not one that I particularly love. But let us know in the comments if you agree that This Is Her is one that people should check out. I'm going to end with an unlikely player for this list, but definitely one that is a favorite of mine. I loved this fragrance at Hello. I just did. People love to beat up on this one because of the exorbitant price tag, and I have to say I don't blame them, but it's one that I make an exception for because it is just so divine for me. This is Tom Ford's Lost Cherry. Love, love, love this red bottle. Purchased this at the cosmetics company store for over half off and have zero regrets. Does it last the longest? We already know that it doesn't. That's one of the major complaints about this fragrance. But this is, for me, like heaven in a bottle, especially on the opening. It has just this absolutely magnificent, juicy, sweet cherry opening. It's boozy. It has a beautiful, lovely almond note in the fragrance. And I will say this, because the cherry gets really calm, calm, as in it starts to dissipate as the fragrance wears on your skin. And what you're left with, you still get some of that cherry throughout the life, the very short life of the fragrance. I mean, on a good day, I get, you know, 4 hours out of this. If I'm lucky, moisturize well and bolster it with oil or something like that, I may get up to 6 hours. But I just love it so much. The cherry stays, although it calms down and gets faint. And what comes forward is this vanillic almond booziness along with sandalwood. There's a little bit of spice like cinnamon and some other notes in it. But the almond is there throughout the fragrance for me. And I love it. It's a creamy, sweet almond, very nostalgic. Reminds me of the holidays when you're sitting around cracking nuts open. Did y'all do that as kids? We did. My grandmother used to have this ceramic candy dish holder type of thing. And she would put all kinds of candies in it, mints, and she would put nuts in it. And there was always a nutcracker there. And we'd sit around, my sisters and I, with our uncles and aunts and whatever. We would crack the nuts and just eat them straight out of the shell. Anyway, there's something about this fragrance that reminds me of those times, really, you know, nostalgic times, good memories. But it is a lovely almond booziness that stays throughout the life of the fragrance, the very short life, even though that beautiful cherry opening kind of calms down. So this is my unlikely player for slot number 12 on my Nutty Fragrances list. Again, check out the pinned comment below for some other ideas for Nutty Fragrances. And if there's one that you'd love to tell our friends here about, please share it either there or in the comments. We'd love to hear your recommendations. We'd love to interact in the comments and get ideas from each other. Hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know your thoughts in the comments. See you in the next one. Take care.